Hello, everybody. Welcome to Managerial Accounting. This is Process Costing. This is my first part, an overview of process costing. So what exactly is process costing? So we're in the world of managerial accounting now. We've left financial. But when we're using process costing, it's going to be for mass production. We'll sometimes refer it to as homogeneous products, or we're producing similar products. And companies like General Mills, Kellogg, Coca-Cola, Pepsi-Cola, they will be going through and making, they're making soda, they're making cereal, and they're not doing it for a individual customer, right? And this is a really important part in terms of why these businesses will use process costing. And just really because they're starting with water or they're starting with grains, and it's going from one process to the next. So to do the accounting for the creation of their products, we're going to be using process costing. Again, it's a similar product. Homogeneous products are the same. So process costing, again, we're going to be using this for mass production. Now, as opposed to, you know, if we're using, why don't we use job order costing? Well, for job order costing, the focus on job order costing is our customer. And just kind of think about it. When we're looking at job order costing, we're keeping track of the work in process by each individual customer. If I'm an attorney, can I bill hours for, you know, say if I have customer X and I spent time on customer Y's account, can I charge another customer for work I'm doing for somebody else? The answer to that is no. If I take my car in for a repair and I'm coming up on my Prius, and all of a sudden I'm getting on my bill a muffler for a BMW, I'm going to be saying, wait a second, what's happening here? So job order costing, we're accumulating costs, labor, materials, and overhead specifically for each individual customer. That's why if we're a mass producer of product, you know, obviously we want everybody to enjoy and have enjoy Coca-Cola and have the Pepsi smile, which dentists love. But as we're going through and doing gigantic, you know, or we're doing mass production, process costing is going to be our better deal. And when we're looking at process costing, more than likely you're going to have multiple different stages of production. But for here on our introduction to managerial accounting course, we're really just going to be focusing on one particular department. Now, what is our goal in process costing? We have these costs that are sitting in work in process, direct materials, work in process conversion. Now, when you hear me say conversion, what do I mean? I'm not trying to convert you into a CPA, at least not yet, but conversion refers to direct labor and factory overhead, or those costs that are converting the materials ultimately into finished goods. So our goal is, in terms of the accounting using process costing, our goal is to figure out, how do we get these beginning direct materials, the direct materials in the month? How do we get our conversion costs, our beginning conversion and conversion during the month? How do we transfer over these costs to finished goods inventory as we're going through and producing our products? So how do we do it? We're going to do it using something called an equivalent unit. Very, very important concept for process costing. What do we mean by equivalent units? Well, the way we're going to look at it is we're going to say that 100 units that are 20% complete is equivalent to 20 units that are 100% complete. The reason why this becomes so important for process costing is that as we're going through and trying to figure out how do we transfer these costs over, the way we're going to be doing it is with equivalent units. And if different units are at different stages of completion in terms of the production process, I'm going to have to kind of go through and say that, well, because we're dealing, remember, we're dealing with homogeneous or we're dealing with similar products. So I'm able to go through and say, through the process of equivalent units, that 100 units at 20% is going to be the same at 20 units at 100%. So what exactly do we mean by equivalent units? Well, in process costing, we have two methodologies that we're going to be focusing on, weighted average and FIFO. Both are exactly the same, except for one particular exception, and that is how we treat beginning inventory. In weighted average, the beginning, all of our beginning inventory units or our beginning inventory equivalent units, no matter how many, how much they say they're complete, we're going to assume that they were 100% complete during the period. And the reason why is when we're doing our cost per equivalent unit, we're going to be including those costs in the cost per equivalent unit. Under FIFO, the beginning equivalent units are computed by determining the amount needed to make the equivalent units 100% complete. So for example, if I have 10,000 units that are only 20% complete as to materials in my beginning inventory, I'm going to need my equivalent units are going to be 80% to make those 100% complete. And again, process costing for many students is by far one of the more challenging subjects. We're going to go through plenty of examples. I have other videos on this too. I'm just making new videos because it's more fun. Beginning inventory costs are not included in the cost per equivalent unit, but rather they are immediately transferred to cost of goods sold. Let's just take a look at this. So if I'm doing weighted average, under weighted average, I'm going to take the total cost of my work in process. And again, I'm going to take these costs, divide it by my equivalent units. I'm going to get a cost per equivalent unit. I'm going to take my units that I completed and then multiply that by the cost per equivalent unit to transfer it over to finished goods inventory. I'm also going to be doing the same for my conversion costs. Again, what are conversion? Conversion costs are going to be direct labor and factory overhead. It's what we need to do to make those direct materials into a final product. Under FIFO, the assumption is different. And this is the key thing where the first thing I like to do whenever I have a FIFO problem is I want to take those beginning direct material costs and move them out immediately to finished goods inventory, because that's going to remind myself when I'm going through and computing those beginning equivalent units, this is how this is going to go through and work. So I want to thank you for joining me here today on this very first video. Please feel free to leave your questions below, and I appreciate you liking and subscribing to these videos. Have a great day, and I look forward to seeing you on the next one.